He found a match. Okay. Dude, did he just find a match? I hope that was 30 seconds. I hope that's a 30-second delay. Otherwise, we're going to be playing each other again. Because I found a match right when he found a match. Am I fated to only play him? Okay. God. Oh, Jesus. Thankfully, not another Cammy. It's just weird that some days it just ends up this way all the time.
Round one.
Okay.
Fight.
Not a good start on the anti-air game. Oh, okay, that's interesting. I stood up. Oh boy, Laura. Is this actually the Pink Diamond? Is this the Pink Diamond? The KI player? Yeah, I didn't know if she played KI or not. I mean, I don't know if she played Street Fighter or not. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Ooh. I was supposed to be standing roundhouse, not towards heavy kick. Oh, stand meteor kick. Nice, okay. Yeah, this character is fun. This character has all sorts of craziness built in. Yeah, I'm wondering if this is the Pink Diamond, because she's super good at KI. She's easily one of the best at KI right now. Oh, she left. Okay, well, there you go. Never mind. It's interesting. There was actually, Javits put up a poll, and he said, who do you fear fighting the most? Do you fear Laura, Balra, Yirian, or Guile the most? And the answer actually was Laura. People actually put Laura in there more than Yirian and more than Guile and more than Balrog, which I found was kind of interesting. Like, I hate fighting Yirian the most. Yeah, Laura is a frustrating character to deal with because you have to know all of her setups. You have to know pretty much everything that she wants to do. The reason why it's tough to do that against Laura is because all of her setup endings look the same. Like, you want to remember after command throw or after volt charge, blam, you know, kind of things like, what is she? Like, but it's like they all feel the same. They all feel like it's the same knockdown, the regular throw. They all have the same kind of animation, the same kind of feel. It's hard to keep your brain distinguished between the different knockdowns to remember which one she's plus this on, which one she's plus this on. Because on one of the knockdowns, she can do a jab elbow and she's plus one. On another knockdown, she can dash forward and she's zero. But if she dashes forward on the other knockdown, she's negative one, and that's not a real thing. There's all these like little things about the way that you have to fight Laura. Like, honestly, if all the endings looked different, I feel like it would actually make fighting her a lot easier. Like, if it was, is this a Ricky fan? Is this a fan of Ricky? I didn't get a chance to see what that video is, Haza. I'll check it in just a second.
Round one. Fight.
Okay. Interesting. Armor. not what I meant to do. Bad timing on that jump. The running bear grab. You went for the running bear grab in the corner. That's not Ricky. That's 100% not Ricky. Picking Cammy for sure. Right when he jumps, of course. Man, I can't beat that crouching light punch. I can't beat that crouching light punch. Oh my god. You lose. Ah, crouching light punch is like the hardest part to figure out in this matchup. How's it going, hallowed? Are you willing to play against someone so much lower than you again? Yeah, okay. You are. Oh, I'm way older than Yipes. Are you kidding me? Yipes is a baby, literal baby, compared to me. So weird. That's not what I wanted to do. Actually killed. I'm surprised. Very, very, very surprised. Ultra David is slightly older than Yipes, but not by much. Fight. I did that too early last time, but I'm doing it again, damn it! See, the crazy thing about this fight, like, I feel like it goes either way. There's some matches, sometimes you play this match and it feels like Cammy can't do crap. And then you play some matches and all of a sudden it feels like Zangief can't do crap. So it really just kind of goes both ways, this match. It's an interesting match. Like, that's why I still think it's 5-5. I really do think it's 5-5.
Round one.
How old is James MK, actually? I'm not even sure. I know he's super old school. I think it was actually mid-30s now, I would say. Why you keep doing armor on wake-ups? That's not a good idea. Whoops! Yeah, that fierce button can cause a lot of problems for Zangief, for sure. I'm willing to take jabs because he doesn't get anything off of it without V-trigger. So I'm just gonna fierce all day. And just hope I priority system it like that. Out of here. Is it gonna kill? Is it gonna kill? It's not gonna kill. He's done that every time in that situation. Woo! Ooh. Oh, Tuba Tej, 27, is super young. Super, 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 super young. Yeah, Gamer B and I both have Asian genes. We definitely have that advantage. The Asian genes is a beautiful, beautiful thing to have, so. Daigo was a nurse. It was a nurse. Everybody's DPs in Street Fighter 4 was a more reliable anti-air. Eris does in fact live on Mount Doom. That's actually not one of the troll rumors or anything like that. That's actually true. He does live on Mount Doom. Incross, I feel 60. I so feel 60, so he's looking for a match right now. Okay. I'm not going into that, Mr. Henry. I'm not going into that because you said he's looking for a match. You said he's looking for a match. So what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to check out what Ahaza is trying to post for me here.
You need a...
Ooh, interesting. Oh, okay. I'll definitely check that out. I'll definitely check that out later. Let me know if Vicious is looking for a match right now. try to interrupt the knee, because bad reaction. That's just all it was. It's just slow reaction. Oh, he found a match. Okay, sweet. Okay. Needs to kill him though. That shit is sick. Asians do suddenly shrink. In fact, I'm not too far away from the age in which I will shrink and then all of a sudden be wearing those colored, clear sun visors on my head. I'll be wearing khaki shorts and a really bad t-shirt with a giant beer gut and a fanny pack sitting on my side. Like, it's just all gonna happen all at once. It's a call for all players, for all Asian people, that when they get to that age, they have to all of a sudden look old as hell. Oh, god awful, huh? Balrog is super good, though. Balrog is a super strong character, but you have to understand all of the mix-ups. That he has off of his V-trigger. That's the key right there. Whoops. Oh jeez, that was a far walk. Whoops. Interesting. Okay, this is a very forward moving heavy Balrog here. Okay, shimmy ability here is high. Oh, you recovered in time? Full screen sweep. I risked it all. I played PRog casually at ESL, but he wasn't using Balrog. He was using another character. He's using Alex, actually. So I'm gonna have to figure, yeah, because he's hitting buttons a lot, I have to figure out how to frame trap him a little better. However, it's not gonna be easy to frame trap him when he's on the offense, because he's frame trapping me. Everything is plus. That should have been a punish. I don't know why it wasn't. God dang it. I always get my combos mixed up when I'm in that situation. I'm always thinking, don't do the target combo, do strong, fierce, uppercut. Then I think strong, fierce is a chain combo. And so, like, my timing gets all messed. This clutch situation here, I've got to figure out. That's right, that's plus three. Dash straight is safe. Is EX low is safe, isn't it?
Final round. Fight.
Ow, that beat my jumping medium kick? Oh, Jesus. Oh my god, okay. Well, there you see right there. There you see the power of Balrog. It's just once he starts getting the offense going, it's really hard to find a button. A lot of it comes down to the fact that when you block his move, it pushes him into a range where your three-frame button isn't effective anymore. No, Peter, I've said that a million times. I actually really hate the priority system and the crush counter system. It's why I want them to bring back close-up moves. I want them to bring back close-up moves and have it so that only the close-up moves have the priority system as well as the crush counter system. I really, really hate the fact that in footsies, that stuff is there, because then it really kind of accentuates the strength of some footsies of some characters over others, because all of a sudden, Yurian and Balrog have these great crush counter buttons, but then like Cammy doesn't have a single crush counter button. Ryu, look at poor Ryu. His crush counter button is Roundhouse, which can't hit anybody, and then he doesn't get anything really off of it if he hits you with it, you know? It's frustrating. It's a very frustrating thing to have to deal with as a player when you're trying to play footsie. So I actually really don't like the crush counter system. I don't like the priority crush counter system. I wish they would bring back close-up moves and have it so that those are the only buttons that did that, so. He's searching for a match right now. No, that's all right, it's all right. I'll get Balrog practice some other time. I'm not worried about it right now. I know Balrog is super good, so I'm good. Oh wow, the Balrog said, good games, I'm honored to play. Okay, good stuff. Yeah, Cammy is definitely the most, quote, honest top tier, because it relies more on you to be able to beat the enemy as opposed to, is he still looking for a match? Is he still looking for a match, or is this, should I go for it? Yeah, the crush counters shouldn't let you dash up and combo, honestly. Or if they do, they should all be very, very frame perfect so that only light punches connect afterwards. The fact that a lot of people can crush counter you and dash up and get medium button combos is a problem. Like, even if it was a light button, if it was one frame, Jesus Christ, I knew it was him. I knew it was him. Oh my God. Why do they just want to make us fight each other? Why is this happening? God!
Round one. Fight!
I think Akuma's good. I don't think he's great. I think he's like mid-tier maybe. Jeremy? Confirming that into a combo instead of going for a risky throw. in the God's name just happened? Oh, this fight is so dumb. It's literally just two people walking around poking all day. There's nothing else you can do in this fight. Like, it's interesting, when Punk actually played K-Brad at S by SW and was like, I'm gonna beat you with your own character. Like, I honestly felt like that proved nothing. Because I think Cammy is just such a dumb matchup that it really doesn't come down to who's a better player anymore. Like, I just think it's like a stupid matchup. It's just like, it's not, or there's no measure of skill in Cammy versus Cammy. Like, Cammy is just like this totally random match. Yeah, so like when Punk played Cammy against K-Brad, it was kind of like a genius thing to do, because K-Brad probably knows in his heart that it has nothing to do with who's actually stronger, but K-Brad knew if he lost, everybody would laugh at him and Punk wouldn't be made fun of if Punk lost that matchup. So it was a psychological advantage that was huge, because Punk has a decent Cammy. And he basically kind of removed a lot of the skill from the game by forcing a Cammy mirror, you know what I mean? Vega doesn't have set play. He's got more just like real normal play, basically. He's like Ryu. He has to play super honest. And so he doesn't really have much he can do. Is he still looking for a match? Is he still looking like a match for a match? Or should I not play this match? What should I do? Mr. Henry, tell me, what should I do? I don't think Xiaohai would beat both, to be honest with you. I really don't think he would. Mr. Henry, what's he do? Oh, shoot. It's too late. Stupid 30-second delay. Okay, I'm just going to assume Jeremy is in a match, so I'm just going to take this one here. This is the Wi-Fi blues here, ladies and gentlemen. I'm stuck on Wi-Fi right now, unfortunately. Oh my god, are you serious? Are you freaking serious? Jesus Christ! Seriously, dude? I mean, Jesus Christ, what the hell is wrong with this? What the hell is wrong with this thing, dude? Jesus. Oh my god. Oh great, and now we ended up in this situation here where the backgrounds got all screwed up. gotta figure out how to, dude, like, I have never had this problem before, but it might just be Wi-Fi, so. I'm so scared to accept matches now. I don't know what to do. Every match I accept is gonna be vicious over and over and over again. I don't know what to do. Dude, that's the like the sixth or seventh time we've been matched up together today. We have played each other so many times, and I don't want to keep playing that match. Dude, I hate this stream delay. There's no way that I can be told on time whether it's right or not. I just want to play random people online, not the same guy over and over and over and over again. It would be different if we weren't both playing Cammy too. If he was playing Karen, I would just, fine, I would play him every once in a while. But the fact that it's Cammy every single time, like, I hate that match. That match is like so garbage. That's crazy to me that in that amount of time that Vicious actually can finish his match. That's so fast. Is he not getting rematches or something like that? I would imagine with two of them it would be different. What the hell? I got hit and then I blocked a hit and then was thrown immediately afterwards. Round two. I was trying to block that. Just gonna keep throwing. I gotta learn how to hit confirm jab jab in the drill instead of always going for throw. Always going for throw.
Final round.
Shoot. That's what I did the first time and it didn't come out. Came out as drill, so I really wanted it to go. Shimmy him after he blocked me, but he was just like, throw! So that actually became frame trap territory then, so that I should actually frame trap him instead of actually trying to shimmy him. Interesting.
Round one. Fight.
Buttons, buttons. Okay, okay. I didn't do that. Gotta figure out why that comes out all the time. I hate that. Whoops, he stood up and crouched, and that triggered my my shimmy reaction. Nice. Okay, okay. That's not a mod. This is an actual costume that was taken away. You can't get it right now. Whoops. Oh, I'm just playing really badly right now. I like his movement. He's got good movement here. Oh my god, I'm just running into things now. Jeez, I should be punishing that, but I'm not. Because I'm having bad reactions. I'm having bad online reactions. Oh, okay, okay.
You lose.
You don't fight a lot of Nashes these days. You don't get a lot of practice against this character anymore these days, so. But I was playing too much into his game. I was trying to get in on him. I have that problem where when the opponent plays this good defense, it becomes this kind of thing where I feel like I have to break his defense because I want to figure out how to challenge his defense, as opposed to backing off and just letting it come naturally. Whenever someone plays a good defense, it triggers something in my brain that I really want to solve that puzzle. And it causes me to run into things and get hit by a lot of things, so. But yeah, like when I block that, when I block the Sonic Scythe, I can punish it every time with a drill. And I just didn't have the reaction for it. I would just block it and end up doing nothing, so. What are we talking about? Are we talking about Resident Evil all of a sudden? This is the stick that I'm using right now. It's Guilty Gear stick. I don't know why my stream chat thing isn't working, by the way, on the screen. I apologize to people about that. I have bigger eyes? That's weird. I never knew I had bigger eyes. I'm Asian. My eyes should just be naturally small. Sinfulzer. Sinfulzer. I don't think this is the Balrog that I faced earlier. Yeah, to get rid of the jacket, it's up, and then the two light buttons, and then medium punch. So three punches plus light kick. Three punches plus light kick.
Round one.
Dude, that jumping HK cross-up was such an accident, I think. Tech, which means I should be able to get a shimmy on him, potentially. Still teching, huh? Nice. Why is he dash so fast? Oh, am I dead? This is a throw techer. This is definitely a throw techer. So I can shimmy this guy a lot.
Round two.
Thank you for the subscription, Master Gear. Much appreciated. Ow! he dashed right through my crouching medium punch. And then he went low. I just saw something happen. I was mashing jab and it didn't work. I am the champ! Couldn't tell what side I was gonna end up on. My throws are too obvious right now. Not gonna kill. Woo! The shimmies. I know, right? They even showed like nostalgia costumes and then they didn't actually release any of them. I have no idea what happened. Dude, so Mr. Henry, I'll have to tell you about ISDD. He's actually not a mean person. Like, he's the biggest jerk on the internet, like when he's like talking about stuff. But then when you meet him in line, like when you meet him in person, he's like super nice. God, gotta stop going for those obvious throws there. Woo, that just beat my crouching medium kick. So fast, he's so good. Whoops. That was unfortunate that the first one hit me out of the air, so I was able to recover on the ground and punish him. That was so scrambly. Oh. Jesus. Oh, just a little too early. Yeah. Empty jumps, baby! Empty jumps! Empty jumps! Woo!
You win!
Sobaso! Sobaso!
Woo! That was close. That was good fights. Those are good fights right there. Cien, I mean, because of character, he wasn't top five. What did you play against as Cammy against a guy with a good Sonic Boom game? You just really got to be patient against Guile. So like I said, I have that same problem too. When you fight against a good Guile and he throws Sonic Booms and he has really good defense, what he's doing is goading you into trying to break that defense. And if you oblige to that, it's that much easier for him to beat you. The best way to fight against him is to play more patient, pick your moments to get in there, and that's what I have to do too. Cien, as a player, as a human being, is like one of the strongest players in the world. Like, that guy is ridiculous. You know, I need to do this sequence more, basically. I need to do medium punch into medium punch, because I always do medium punch into crouching medium punch, and crouching medium punch definitely much more negative on block. So Cammy crouching medium punch is 1 on block, but stand medium punch is 3 on block. So if I learn to do standing medium punch, that gets me a lot more pressure instead of always going for stand medium punch, crouching medium punch. Because when I do that, I'm only +1. I can't get up as close. I know that it doesn't knock back as far. And holy crap, I got to fight against the Urien. Oh. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Urien, lots of jumps. And get to the air anymore. And don't try to fight his buttons on the ground. Do not fight his buttons on the ground. Oh, Fang could definitely be still a pocket character. In fact, he said after the patch notes that he'll be buffed again, so he actually feels like he might be able to play a decent Fang. He might be able to have him as a secondary character. Totally lose now. Oh my god, Jesus. I should have just ran away. Why didn't I run away? Why didn't I run away? Why didn't I run away? Oh man, Jesus. He's so tall. Oh man. Urien ain't top tier. Urien ain't top tier, my ass. Character is so good, dude. Like, everyone you talk to says that Urien is pretty much top three. Ricky, Justin, F-Champ. Every one of those guys says that.
Round one. Fight.
Okay, buttonsy, low jabby, Urien. Look at that. Every time, low jab. ever try that stupid move? Really, we're gonna crouch jab in every situation humanly imaginable? Broken too. I'm not saying Cammy's not broken. Cammy's hella broken. Oh shit. Ow. Oh, look at that. 300 damage off of a crush counter in footsies. I'm so sad. I'm so sad about that. Oh man. I'm so sad. I had that. That's the worst thing about it is after those tackles, like there's really nothing that you can do about it. Like, you can jab him, but he's just like, whatever, I don't care. Go ahead and jab me. This guy is a throw-techer. So I gotta shimmy him more. I don't think you fulfilled your end of the deal, did you? I don't see you subscribing right now. Oh my god, it was fun. I did that way too early. Woo! Okay, that was just fortunate timing on my part.
You win.
Oh, man. What do you think are the top five fighters in SF5 and why? Rashid is definitely in the argument for top five. A lot of people have talked about Rashid as a potential top five character. He's super good. Rashid may have the only button that's better than Urien's standing heavy punch, which is crouching heavy punch for Rashid, except it just doesn't lead to 300 damage, but it covers so much. The top five, in my opinion right now, number one is Cammy, number two is Urien, number three is probably Balrog or Laura, and so that's three and four, and then five is probably Guile. Those are my top five sort of right now, but within that, those top five, they really kind of mishmash around each other. They're kind of like bleh, bleh. They can like mix around and stuff like that. Rashid is probably right up there along with Karen. Let me see if all the, like, if I had to name my top 10 right now, my top 10 would be Balrog, Cammy, Guile, Ibuki, Karen, Laura, Nikali, Rashid, Urien, and Mika. Yeah, that's my top 10 right there. Wow, it just turned out to be exactly 10. So in the second tier of 10, five characters, I would probably have Rashid, Mika, Nikali, Karen, and Ibuki. So those are the other five that I would have in there. So the top five for me are Cammy, Guile, Balrog, Laura, Urien, and then it would be Ibuki, Karen, Nikali, Mika, and what was the last one that I said? Shoot. Did I double Urien up there? Ibuki, Karen, Nikali, Mika, and Rashid. That's what it is. Rashid, yeah. Geef, no, I don't have him in top 10. Like, a lot of people say that he's super good, but, like, I think he still has to work super hard. Interesting. That only hits once. I'm not sure I believe Geef is top 10 just yet. He has a couple of really, really bad matchups that I just... Yeah, one of his bad matchups is Dalsum, so like you're not going to run into that unless you literally fight against one of four people in the United States. But he has trouble against Dalsum, he has trouble against Birdie. He just has to work so hard in so many matches that I just don't feel like Zangief is quite top 10 just yet. Yeah, it's true. If he grabs you with one fierce or heavy punch SPD or an EX SPD, like life sucks and everything, and he just basically will destroy you at that point in time. But I just don't think that he's at that. Oh my God, really? Hey Brad, what have you done? You've made this character too popular. That was cute. I'm glad I chose the right button and not standing light punch.
Round two.
Cammy, top one in boring characters to watch. Agreed. Not agreed necessarily completely, but she's definitely not exciting to watch. Ah, too far for the jab to hit. Oops. See, that's why you should hit that button. Haha, I stole your trick. You know, honestly, that's one thing that I need to do more is I block a lot. And so whenever I block plus moves, I respect it a lot and block it. And when opponents do that, they get to put me in a mix of, I need to disrespect them every once in a while. Just go for EX uppercuts in the middle of block strings like that. Oh my god! Just gonna drill me like that? Nice! Well, somebody else here has their anti-airs on point. Oh my god. Oh my god! You should know not to hit a button after that EX, that trigger dive kick. Nice confirm into V trigger.
Final round. Fight.
The hell? Was that a combo? Huh. Catches me during my crouching animation. I didn't know what side I was on, I forgot what cami I was. Whoops! I dropped my combo and then he mashed out an uppercut. I was very fortunate on my part. Momochi's already talking about it. That's why he played Rashid at South by Southwest. He's trying to learn a top tier. He wants to get Rashid, learn that top tier character, and be ready for E-League. Dude, I don't know where Punko went. I have no idea what happened to Punko. Bison? I feel like Bison's really good. It's funny because I mentioned my top 10, but honestly, once I get through like 11 through 15, those are all still super good characters. Like I put Bison there, I'd probably put Zangief there. That's where they would show up. But even though that's middle of the pack, like I consider that more like there's S tier, A plus tier, and A tier. Like that's kind of how I would rank it right now. So I would have, who would I put in that tier? Like Bison is in there. Zangief is in there. Maybe Akuma, maybe Ken. Ken is a tough one right now because Sometimes Ken seems amazing. Sometimes Ken seems like total, utter dog shit. And it's like, it's hard to figure out where he lands, really. I guess the next five would actually be a little bit harder for me to decide, to be honest. Oh, this is not looking good. Yeah, okay. But for sure in that next five, I would probably have Akuma, Zangief, and M. Bison in there around like 11, 12, and 13. Dalsum? I don't think Dalsum is ass like a lot of people do. A lot of people think Dalsum is just like trash, like he's bottom three or whatever like that. I wouldn't do that. I don't even think he's bottom five, to be honest with you. Like, the way Dalsum and Champ use him, like, yes, they struggle and they have to do a lot of work, but I just don't think that he's as bad as they say he is, because you see guys like Commander Jesse and Champ and Arturo doing super well at tournaments all the time. So I don't know if I put him in that next five, however, because bottom five to me, like, honestly, is like Ryu, Fong, maybe Jury. Although in Texas, I played a really good Jury who destroyed my Cammy. God, he bodied me so badly. He was doing it with standing medium punch, and I couldn't do anything. Yeah, Nash, Alex, yeah. So probably Nash, Alex, Jury, Fong, and Ryu. Maybe even Chun-Li. Dude, my... Didn't quick rise. Faded. Dude, where is my meaty? Oh, he's waking up with standing jab. He's using that tech. Oh, nice try. The reason why it's so infuriating to lose in Street Fighter V is because a lot of the times when you die, you're not even sure why it happened. Like, it doesn't make any sense to you why you're dying a lot of the times. It just feels like someone's in your face hitting buttons, and you're hitting buttons, and you lose, and for some reason you can't do the same back to them, and it doesn't make any sense, and it's really, really frustrating. It's a very, very frustrating thing to do, to play against. Fight. So slow. Yeah. loudmouth? Who's the loudmouth that we're talking about here? Ooh. I really gotta stop using that move. I really gotta stop using that stupid spinning turnknuckle. Why do I use it? I'm like tempted to want to build up my V trigger, but it's such a bad idea and I die because of that button every time. Oh, that was beautiful. I have no idea what's going on. I hate this fight so much.
You lose.
I hate this fight. I hate this fight so much.
Round one. Fight.
How did I not win that jab exchange? I block a dive kick, I feel like I'm negative, but when I block their dive, when they block my dive kick, I feel like I'm negative. I'm just aiming dive kicks poorly or something like that. Oh my god. God, this is such a true test of my mental strength right now, is that I keep running into cammies over and over again. If it's not one cammy, it's gonna be another cammy. Jesus Christ, fuck my life.